शांति 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 श्री चिद्गणेश अनुमोमयम् सुखं नित्यं सत्प्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूप अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धे त्रिक्यत्न निर्मलं अपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम तदेव अन्नमत्तमिति मे निश्चिता मतिः। सच्चित आनंद इज स्वरूप ऑफ आत्मा एंड सत चित आनंद दे आर नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ईच अदर। द सेम आत्मा इज कॉल्ड अस सत चित एंड आनंद वेर एज दे आर नॉट विद डिफरेंसेस अमोंग देम ऑल्दो द वर्ड्स आर डिफरेंट। फर्दर वी ऑल्सो सॉ आत्मा इज नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ब्रह्म, ब्रह्म स्वरूप एव आत्मा एंड ऑल दिस हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड लॉजिकली नाउ विद श्रुति एज बेसिस ट्राइंग टू कंक्लूड इन दैट ऐक्य। वॉट एवर लॉजिक वर्क्स वेल वी हैव यूज दैट। इफ ब्रह्म इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम आत्मा वॉट विल हैपन, इट विल बिकम अनात्मा एंड आत्मा भिन्न अनात्मा इज जड़ा, therefore ब्रह्म विल बिकम जड़ा। नाउ नो दार्शनिका आस्तिक दार्शनिका विल एक्सेप्ट दैट ब्रह्म इज जड़ा। वन मे गेट अवे बाय सेइंग आत्मा इज जड़ा विच ऑल्सो वी हैव रिफ्यूटेड। हाउएवर सेइंग ब्रह्म इज जड़ा इज श्रुति विरुद्ध, therefore देर कैनॉट बी भिन्नत्वं बिटवीन ब्रह्म एंड आत्मा। तस्मात् ब्रह्म आत्मनो न भिन्नं ब्रह्म स्वरूप एव आत्मा। दैट इज वेयर वी स्टॉप यस्टरडे। उपाधि भेदं विना आत्मनो ब्रह्मणस्य भेदो नास्ति। देन व्हाई इज दिस प्रतीति ऑफ भिन्नत्वं? भिन्नत्वं इज राइट इन अवर फेस, दैट इज ड्यू टू उपाधि भेद। वी हैव सीन दिस, वी नो दिस। एकम एव चैतन्यं सर्व प्रपंचस्य मायायाश्च अधिष्ठानं भवति। So, Brahma is not different across Upadhis, it is one. Whether it is Maya Upadhi, Ishwara, where Brahma Chaitanya is one, and not segmented across Vyashti also, individuals, where Avidya becomes the Upadhi. So, for the, when you are looking at the Karya Prapancha and the Karta Ishwara, Ishwara has the Maya as Upadhi. Therefore, adhisthana of Maya is Brahma. Prapancha is a karya. Karya, adhisthana will also be Brahma. So, ekam eva chaitanyam sarva prapanchasya maya yascha adhisthanam bhavati tasmat tad brahma iti kathyate. This adhisthana is called as Brahma. This vyapaka tattva, brahmi viruddhau, we have seen in the last patha. Tadeva chaitanyam अविद्यायाः व्यष्टिदेहादीनां च अधिष्ठानं भवति एंड ऑल्सो द अधिष्ठान फॉर इंडिविजुअल ऑल्सो बिकॉज अविद्या इज द उपाधि देयर बाय देयर इज नो सेकेंड ब्रह्म देयर नीड नॉट बी अनदर ब्रह्म लॉजिकली ऑल्सो देयर इज नो प्रयोजन ऑफ ब्रिंगिंग अनदर ब्रह्म और differentiation in Brahma or segmentation in Brahma just to explain the vyavastha of many. Plurality can be explained by upadhi tasmad atma iti kathyate. This vyashti deha adhisthana Brahma is called as atma, whereas samashti adhisthana has a nama bheda as Brahma, but there is no swarupatah bheda. Tatpadasya laksham Brahma iti kathyate. This tatpada which stands for Brahma at the samashti level, the laksharta is Shuddha Chaitanya called as Brahma. Tvam padasya laksham atma iti kirtyate. And the Shuddha Chaitanya laksharta of Tvam pada, vachyartha being jiva at the vyashti level, that Tvam pada lakshatma, the laksharta is atma. ईश्वर साक्षी तत्पदस्य लक्ष्यो भवति जीव साक्षी त्वंपदस्य लक्ष्यो भवति। सो व्हाट इज द लक्ष्यार्थ देयर? Shuddha Chaitanya, which is Ishvara Sakshi and Jeeva Sakshi. At the Vyashti level, Jeeva Sakshi, at the Samashti level, Ishvara Sakshi. But at the Sakshi level, there cannot be any Vyashti Samashti Bheda also really. So Laksharatha is Shuddha Chaitanya, which is Eka. Vyashti Sanghato Upaita Chaitanyam Jeeva Sakshi, Samashti Sanghato Upaita Chaitanyam Ishvara Sakshi. And when you talk about Upadhi Bheda, there is no real Veda. Upadhi Krita Bheda is Kalpita Bheda. Yadyapi Jeevasya Ishvarasya cha Ekatvam na Yujyate, Tathapi Jeeva Sakshina Ishvara Sakshinascha Upadhi Bheda Bhedaha Swarupata Ekatvam cha Asti. So Upadhi Bheda Bhedaha Ekatvam eva Siddhyati. When you say Upadhi Krita Bheda, then it is not real Bheda at all. In fact, by saying Upadhi Krita Bheda, you are talking about Abheda. So that is what is said here. Yadyapi Jeevasya Ishvarasya cha Ekatvam na Yujyate. Samashti and Vyashti cannot become one as it is. You cannot have this Sarvashaktiman, Sarvajna, Ishvara become one with Jeeva who is Alpashaktiman, Alpajna. You cannot have as it is Abheda. Between the two, there cannot be Abheda as it is. Jeeva can never become Ishvara. Ishvara can never become Jeeva as it is. So, Ekatvam na Yujyate. Tathapi, however, Jeeva Sakshinah Ishvara Sakshinascha. The Sakshi Aumsha, if you want to talk about Aumsha, which is not really Aumsha. Aumsha what Aumsha? Because in discussing, we have to look at the Chetana Aumsha. Although there is nothing other than Chetana Aumsha, we have to discuss as an Aumsha because Aumsha means that partless part. With that understanding, we have to talk about this Chaitanya Aumsha, which is the real Aumsha. So we can say the real and the Mithya, which has got mixed up. In that Sada Aumsha and Mithya Aumsha, when you talk about Mithya Aumsha and Sada Aumsha, Mithya has no reality at all. So even if you call it as a Mithya part and a Sat part, the Sat is not really a part at all. It is the whole, but still, from the perspective of the Mithya Aumsha, it is another Aumsha. So that Sakshi Aumsha is not different. Tathapi Jeeva Sakshina Ishvara Sakshinascha Upadhi Bhedad Bhedaha Swarupatah Tu Ekatvam Asti. Yatha Mathe Sthitasya Ghatakashasya Matakashasya cha Upadhi Bhedam Vina Swarupato Bhedo Nasti Tatha Atmano Brahmanascha Upadhi Bhedam Vina Bhedo Nasti. So Ghatakasha Matakasha example we know. There is no real Bheda between the Akasha. It is a Namakurta Bheda and that Nama is Ghata or Matha. And those are also forms. So name and form are the Upadhis which are used for transaction. In Vyavahara, you say Ghatakasha, Matakasha, they are different. But wherever the form of the Ghata and form of the Matha is, wherever the boundary of the Matha and Ghata is, there itself Akasha also is. So Akasha is not segmenting anything, Akasha is not being segmented at all by the Ghata and the Matha boundaries also. So these Upadhis are only for Vyavahara, but they do not really segment the Akasha. Similarly with Jivatma and Paramatma. Upadhi Bhedam Vina Bhedo Nasti. Without the Upadhi, you cannot have Bheda, you cannot have Vyavahara itself without having Nama and Rupa. Atma Iti Brahma Iti Cha Ekam Eva Vastu. There is only one Vastu which is real. Whether you call it as Atma or Brahma, it is the same Satchidananda Vastu. Brahma Swarupasya Atmanaha Janma Rahitattva Pratipadanam. Now is this Brahma born as Jiva? Atma. Atma, does Atma go through Shadavikaras? Or is it Ajab Brahma? Ajaha Atma, Ajam Brahma. So that inquiry is being done now. Atmano janmana yujyate. You cannot say that Atma has janma. Soyam brahmarupa Atma janma rahita. Atmanaha janmangikare so anitya syat. Why? Why should Atma not be said to have janma? Because as soon as you accept janma for Atma, then Atma will become anitya. Even in Nayayika Paksha, Atma is not anitya. Atma may be jada, but anitya, it isn't. So nitya, vyapaka, multiple jada atmas are there in Nyaya Paksha also. Anitya Atma is not acceptable to anyone. It shouldn't be acceptable to anyone. Barring the Shunyavadi, who we really don't care about because Nastika. In the Astika Paksha, you cannot have someone saying that Atma is not there. Even in the Nastika Paksha, the person who says that Atma is Anitya, Kshanika, Kshanika Vijnana Rupa, who is getting moksha? So the logical conclusion into Atma being Anitya is a failure in all ways. It is not helping anyone. You may logically win the battle, but you have lost the war. Samsara war you have lost because you will always be a samsari. Or someone else will be a samsari, but you yourself won't be there. What kind of moksha would it be where you do not exist? The sadhaka who is struggling for moksha is trying to commit suicide. It is ridiculous. Soyam brahma rupa atma janma rahita atmano janmangi kare so anitya syat. Because the first janma vikara if you accept, then all other vikaras will follow, including the nasha. Paraloka vadina astikasya na etadishtam. The Puro Mimamsaka or the other who says, another Dvaiti or Vishishtadvaiti who says there is moksha elsewhere in another loka, be it in Swarga or in Vaikuntha, Kailasa, whatever it is, not having your own Swarupa, losing yourself and trying to gain something, who is the gainer? Who will reach the other loka? Na etadishtam. यदि आत्मा उत्पत्ति नाशवान तदा प्रथम जन्मनि पूर्व कर्म विना एव सुख दुख भोगः भोगं विना एव कृतस्य कर्मणः नाशश्च आपद्येताम. It is not a single issue. Ishvara, who is acceptable to all astikas in one way or the other, would be giving the phala not in keeping with karma. So those who accept Ishvara as karma phala data, on what basis will Ishvara give karma phala? Atma has janma. That Atma has janma which didn't have karma. Because the earlier Atma is gone, then on what basis will Atma be born into a particular sharira? There is no karma to associate. And the struggle that one has done to gain Swargadi Loka, Punya that has been earned, cannot be associated with anyone. So it is random, it is chaotic. You will not have a meticulous setup of this karma, which is very difficult to understand, but we have an overview. We know as to karma has unflinching, unfailing result. That setup will not work anymore. And if you accept Ishvara, then you will have to accept that kind of Ishvara who is not Karunamaya Ityadi. All your bhajans have gone for a toss because this Ishvara is giving random phala. You do something, you get something else. You get result of karma that you have not done, and you don't get results of karma that you have done. For a Purva Mimamsaka who does not accept Ishvara, for him the karma itself has the shakti to give the result by creating Adrushta. That Adrushta Vashat Janma for whom again there is no association of karma. Without karma one gets results, without having a result one is performing karma. This kind of ridiculous conclusion we have to arrive at. Yadi atma utpatti nashavan tada prathama janmani purva karma vina eva sukha dukha bhogaha. There is sukha and dukha bhoga without karma. Karma may be there, but how will you associate with atma? So vina purva karma vina eva means this particular atma does not have any purva karma because nashavan, new atma has been born. Bhogam vina eva kritasya karmanah nashascha apadyetam, and all the karma that one has done in one janma is lost after nasha. Karma may be there, but it is floating. Where will it go? It has no one to associate with. Tasmad atmanah kartrutva bhoktrutva angikarya api janma nasha rahita eva saha angikarya. This atma who is a karta bhokta, there also janma nasha rahita. Kartrutva will no longer be there when there is nasha. So, if there has to be kartrutva bhoktrutva for atma, even in that paksha, what should you conclude? You should conclude that this atma is janma nasha rahita. Otherwise, kartrutva being there, bhoktrutva can't be there. Bhoktrutva in that janma may be there, but what about the other janma which follows in keeping with this janma's karma? So that kartrutva and bhoktrutva will not have any connection across janmas if the atma is janma nasha sahita. Therefore, janma nasha rahita eva atma angikaryaha. Apija atmanaha janmangikare karanam vina kasyachidapi vastunaha utpatya darshanat atmanaha kasmachit karanat janma vaktavyam. Now, this kind of a setup, random setup, is not acceptable. This chaotic without any particular rule. Even if you give a general outlook, you have to say that gahana karmano gati, but still some setup has to be there which will encourage the person to continue in life with hope in this janma and paraloka. So in this loka and paraloka there has to be something that attracts the jiva, otherwise why would one continue in samsara and do anything? So atmanah kasmachit karanat janma vaktavyam. What is the reason for which atma has taken janma? That has to be mentioned. If karanam vina kasyachidapi vastuna utpatya darshanat atmanah janmangikare, if we accept atma is born, then why is it born? Some karana has to be shown, because without karana you cannot have atma janma also. Tattuna sangachheta, if you say there is karana for atma's janma, not the shariras or the sukshma sharira associating with the stula sharira, but atma itself being born, that is without karana it is not acceptable, and with karana also it is not possible. What karana will you give? Why? Tata hi yad atmanah karanam tad atmano bhinnam iti vaktavyam. As soon as you say karana, karya karana are different. You cannot have karya preceding the karana. Karana has to precede the karya. Now this karana which precedes the karya is different from the karya. Yad atmanah karanam, that which is karana for atma is different from karya atma. So atmano bhinnam iti vaktavyam, you have to mention that, because if it is one, then there is no birth at all really. You are saying there is atma janma, you are not saying it is manifest. Now that is the difference. So there is no abheda between karana and karya. Karana is bhinna from karya. Karya is atma because atma is taking janma. In that case, atma karana, what is the karana of atma? Atmana janma karanam, atma karanam, tasya atmana bhinnam bhavati, tasmad atmana bhinnam bhavati. So tasmad atmana tad bhinnam, atma bhinnam yat karanam tad vaktavyam, atma bhinnam sarvam atmani kalpitam. and we have seen atma bhinna, whatever is there is what? It is all kalpita in atma. Tasmat tad atmana karanam na bhavet. Kalpita cannot become a karana for kalpana also, let alone sadatma. Yatha rajyau kalpita sarpo na rajyoho karanam bhavati, tatha eva atmani kalpitam vastu atmana karanam na bhavet. You cannot have a kalpita karana. There is no pramana. You have to do kalpana. If you do kalpana, it is this karana is imagined in atma, which is not real. Atma is real. You cannot have kalpita vastu as karana for this sad vastu. Or any kalpita vastu also, adhishthana has to be real. Similarly, karana has to be real. In comparison to the karya, kalpite vastuni amsha bhedosti. In this kalpita vastu, there is an amsha bheda. What is that? Ekasyam rajyo nana purushanam danda sarpaha bhuchidram jaladhara iti nana bhrantayaha bhavanti. In the same adhishthana, there can be multiple kalpanas. So in the same rajju, you can have danda appearing for one purusha, sarpa for another, bhuchidra appearing for yet another person, and jaladhara pratiti for someone else. Iti nana bhrantaya bhavanti. In the same rajju, tasyam bhrantamsha dvayam asti. So in that kalpana, there are two aunshas. One is sat, whereas the other is kalpita. So ekaha samanya idam aunshaha. When you say this is a rajju, this is a rope, this is a snake, this is a stream of water, this is a crack in the ground, this is a stick, there this is that astitvam. Along with that idam, this, the pronoun this, idam, the pronoun idam is continuing, has an anuvritti in each and every situation for each and every person, whoever has the pratiti of danda, sarpa, bhuchidra, jaladhara, whatever, but still idam amsha is definitely there across the purushas. This danda amsha, sarpa amsha, bhuchidra and jaladhara amshas are varying across the pratitis of these people, but the idam amsha has anuvritti. There is vyabhichara in the kalpita, danda, sarpa, bhuchidra, but idam amsha is not kalpita. Idam amsha belongs to the rajju, adhishthana. That is not kalpita and that has anuvritti. There is anvaya across the pratitis of various purushas. But the pratiti vishaya has vyabhichara across various pratitis, across various purushas. So idam amsha is called as samanya amsha. Ekaha samanya idam amshaha. Anyaha sarpadi vishesha amshaha iti. The particulars of vishayas, sarpa, danda, ityadi, they are vishesha amshas. They are varying across all pratitis. Sacha samanya idam amshaha sarpadi vishesha amsheshu sarveshu vyapakaha. Idam amsha pervades across all pratitis. Ayam sarpaha, ayam dandaha, idam bhuchidram, iyam jaladhara, iti evam ritya. Sarpadi vishesha amsheshu idam amsha vyapakosti. The same idam amsha changes gender. In Sanskrit, it changes gender. In English, it will remain same. This is, this is, this is. This is a snake, this is a stick. But in Sanskrita, based on the Vishesha Amsha, the Idam Amsha Namataha will undergo Bheda based on the Vachana and Linga. So Linga Vachana Bheda is there. Other than that, the same Amsha continues. So Pullinge Ayam Sarpaha, Ayam Dandaha, Napunsake Idam Bhuchidram, Strilinge Iyam Jaladhara, but it is the same Idam Amsha which is having Anuvritti. Iti Evam Ritya Sarpadi Vishesha Amsheshu Idam Amsha Vyapako Bhavati. Idam Amsha pervades through and through. सोयं व्यापकः सामान्य इदम् अंशः रज्जुस्वरूपमेव दैट इदम् अंशः वेर यू से दिस दैट टाइम व्हेन द पर्सन इज सेइंग दिस इज अ रोप व्हेन अ पर्सन सीज दिस इज अ स्नेक दिस इज अ स्टिक दैट टाइम व्हेन ही सेज दिस इज अ स्नेक there has to be something on the ground there something in front of him it is not the ground itself it is not the tree itself it is not wherever he is seeing it it is not that location which he is seeing as sarpa he is seeing something in that locus in that location something is being seen what is that that is rajju it is mistaken for a danda sarpa ityadi but there is something which is cognized that something actually cannot be other than rajju because rajju bhinna there is nothing there there is only rajju so he has seen the rajju but missed the rajju having seen something that something is idamamsha that something is rajju the idamamsha belongs to that rajju so when he says I am seeing a snake there is a snake this is a snake when he makes that statement that idam amsha belongs to the rajju it is rajju swarupa itself that's rajju swarupa itself is this is it is predicated to be sarpa instead of rajju so in english also when you say this is a rope there are two segments this is that thisness belongs to the adhisthana the rajju the rope whereas when it is predicated instead of saying the rope which is missed what is being said it is danda so the mix up is at the predication not at the idam amsha at the subject the subjective complement is predicated wrongly so anuye vyatirika shows you that idam amsha is satya whereas the सर्पादि विशेष अंश विच बिलोंग्स टू द विषय विच विषय मिथ्या विषय विच डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट कल्पित विषय दे आर मेनी दे आर डिफरिंग एंड दे आर मिथ्या सो प्रेडिकेशन ऑफ द विषय इज रॉन्ग सोयम व्यापक सामान्य इदम अंश रज्जु स्वरूपमेव तादृश सामान्य इदम अंशस्य ज्ञानमेव भ्रांति कारण रज्जु सामान्य अंश ज्ञानम इति वर्ण्यते सो व्हाट इज दिस सामान्य अंश व्हेन इट इज नोन प्रॉपरली तादृश सामान्य इदम अंशस्य ज्ञानमेव भ्रांति कारण रज्जु सामान्य अंश ज्ञानम इति वर्ण्यते दिस सामान्य अंश रज्जु इज द अधिष्ठान and it the jnana of thisness without knowing this you cannot have bhranti also you have to know the samanya ansha for bhranti also without the samanya ansha jnana there is no karana itself for bhranti also so what is the bhranti karana rajju samanya ansha jnanam that rajju samanya ansha jnana but vishesha ansha ajnana Rajju also has two parts, idam amsha and rajju amsha. Vishesha amsha is missed. So samanya amsha jnana with the vishesha amsha ajnana becomes the karana for sarpa jnana and sarpa vishaya bhranti ityadi, danda ityadi sale also. So yam samanya idam amsha satyaha. This samanya idam amsha is satya. Thisness is real. रज्जु ज्ञानानंतरम् अपि इयम् रज्जुः इति इदम् अंशस्य प्रतीति सत्वात् व्हाई डू यू कॉल इट एज रियल बिकॉज़ नॉट ओनली इट इज व्यापक बट इवन आफ्टर द भ्रांति नाश आफ्टर द ज्ञानोत्पत्ति ऑफ रज्जु विशेष अंश एज रज्जु व्हेन यू से दिस इज अ रोप देन फ्रॉम दिस इज अ स्नेक यू हैव गॉन टू दिस इज अ रोप द दिसनेस कंटिन्यूज not only across kalpita vastus it continues after the kalpita vastu nasha also so when you say ayam sarpaha that time that ayam is the thisness or the idam amsha of the rajju when you say oh sarpo nasti rajju reva asti that time also you say yam rajjuhu. That time also the yam pada is the idam amsha manifestation. So idam amsha is continuing, samanya amsha is continuing after the bhranti nasha also. During the bhranti also it was there, across the bhrantis also it was there. Idam amsha never goes away, and therefore trikala abadita sat is the idam amsha. Idam amsha satya because trikala abhaditam sat. Satyam sadeva satyam. रज्जु ज्ञानानंतरम् अपि इयम् रज्जुः इति इदम् अंशस्य प्रतीति सत्त्वात् यथा भ्रान्तिकाले अयम् सर्प इति सर्पादीनां सह इदम् अंशः प्रतीयते तथा भ्रान्ति निवृत्त्यनन्तरम् अपि इयम् रज्जुः इति रज्ज्वासः इदम् अंशः प्रतीयते. सो रज्ज्वासः और सर्पेण सह इदम् अंशः वर्तते एव. देयर इज अ प्रतीति ऑफ इदम् अंश थ्रू एंड थ्रू. यदि इदम् अंशोऽपि मिथ्या स्यात् तदा सर्पादेरिव भ्रान्ति निवृत्त्यनन्तरम् तस्य इदम् अंशस्य अपि प्रतीतिर् न भवेत्. इफ इदम् अंश वेर नॉट टू बी सत्य, हैड इदम् अंश आल्सो बीन मिथ्या, देन भ्रांति नाश विल, भ्रांति निवृत्ति विल लीड टू इदम् अंश निवृत्ति आल्सो, इदम् अंश नाश विल आल्सो टेक प्लेस एंड यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू से इयम् रज्जुः. दैट जस्टनेस इटसेल्फ वोंट बी देयर, अस्तित्व विल गो अवे. दैट इज द रियल आइडिया देयर. तस्मा सर्पादि भ्रांत व्यापक इदम अंश सत्य अधिष्ठान रज्जु स्वरूप तस्मिन् परस्पर व्यभिचारिण सर्पादय कल्पिता. वेर एवर देर इज व्यभिचार, सो अन्वय व्यतिरेक, व्यतिरेक वेर एवर इट इज देर, दैट इज कल्पित, दैट इज मिथ्या. सर्पादय आर मिथ्या, वेर एज रज्जु इज अधिष्ठान, विच इज अधिष्ठान, विच इज इदम अंश, विच मैनिफेस्ट एज इदम अंश. And that adhisthana is nitya, it is satya. Sarva padarteshu amsha panchaka varnanam. There are five amshas in each padartha, astibhati priya nama rupa. As the panchadashikara Bhagavan Vidyaranyacharya says, sarva padarteshu pancha amsha santi nama rupam astibhati priyam. Astibhati priyam are three different words for what? Sat, chit, ananda. Nama rupa we already know. All these are have to be there in each and every padartha. They are there in each and every padartha. Iti panchaamshaha. When you say ghata, ghata iti akshara samudayo nama. What do you mean when you say ghata? Ghata is a pada. Suptingantam padam. Ghata ha is prathama eka vachananta padam. Which padam? Subantam padam. There is a supratya in the end. It is a noun. Declined noun in prathama ekvachana. So in what is this prathama ekvachana now? This prathama ekvachana in kartari prayoga it is a karta, in karmani prayoga it is karma. So ghataha, when you say ghata, pratipadika also is going to have some meaning even if it is not declined. So when you say ghata iti akshara samudaya, whether you say ghataha, ghataha when you say in usage you have to say ghataha, otherwise you have to say ghata iti. When you say ghata iti, ghate iti, it is going to become a samasa, ghate iti. For convenience and for understanding, we break the padas even within the samasa. So ghataha iti or ghate iti. When you say ghate iti, it is a pratipadikam. That pratipadikam has ghakara, akara, takara, akara. When you decline it, it has a suppada. So pratipadika ghata is also akshara samudaya which has meaning. Otherwise pratipadikam sanya will not fit in. In vyakrana, pratipadika sanya is for krut taddhita samasa or something which is not derived also will have pratipadika sanya. If ghata is derived from a dhatu, then it will have pratipadika sanya. If it is derived from another word using a pratyaya, from another noun using a pratyaya, then also it will have pratipadika sanya. If you derive it from a group of nouns, then it will have a samasa sanya, and then that compound samasa will become pratipadika. Then you can decline it as a noun. So all this krit, taddhita and samasa will make it pratipadika. What if it is none of these? it has some different name, it has some sound. I want to discuss this sound. I want to talk about this sound, which denotes a padartha, or it is a foreign language where I want to interact with that entity, whether a person or a thing, in a different language it has a meaning though. So padartham vina padarthaha na bhavati. So padartham vina padam na bhavati. That pada has a padartha there. That padartha being there, denoted by any word, that word has to be meaningful. And I have to somehow interact in the Sanskrita language. So when I am interacting there, any language, I am talking about Sanskrita because we are dealing with Sanskrita here. In Sanskritam, that ghata or some other word which has no derivation in Sanskritam, still it has to have meaning. And what is that meaning? It is a padartha which it represents. So that nama, when I deal with an entity, I need a nama, name, which has a particular form in the padartha. So nama rupa is there. And this arthavad adhatur apratyaya pratipadikam, that is another sutra for giving the definition of pratipadika. So arthavat, the pada should be arthavat, the akshara samudaya should be arthavat for it to become pratipadika and then become a pada. So for it to be declined as a noun in vyavahara with the prepositions whichever are necessary in other languages, similarly in Sanskrita prepositions are hidden in the pratyaya. In the suffix itself, the meaning of the preposition is there. To get that kind of a pada, you need to have pratipadika first, and that pratipadika has to have artha. Arthavat adhatuhu apratyaya, which is not a dhatu, which is not a pratyaya, but it is arthavat, has artha, has meaning of the padartha. So padartha, padasya artha is to be there in any word for it to be declined and convey meaning in vyavahara. So in other languages, not declined, but we'll say it has to have some preposition. When you make it a karaka, a subject, an object, an instrument, whatever you call it, a locus, a source, whatever it is, to add those appropriate prepositions and make the sentence meaningful to convey the idea, vivaksha, there has to be a padartha associated with the word, and that samudaya, akshara samudaya. So here the example is ghata. Ghata iti akshara samudayo nama, that is nama. Prithu buddhnavartulatvadikam rupam, what is the form, rupa. So in the ghata, ghata has a particular shape, it has a thin neck, it has a mouth. So mouth in a sense, the wherever you pour the water from or into, for example, that is the mouth. Then it has a narrow neck, then it has a huge belly like structure, a particular shape is there, general. So that is what is ghata. Otherwise, how will you recognize a ghata? So it has a particular rupa. When it is introduced, what do you say? Ayam ghataha, this is a pot. How do you know? I have seen it earlier. I know what a pot looks like. I have seen a pot before. But what happens in the first cognition? When you are a child, you don't know pot. That time, somebody is talking about a pot. Ghatamanaya, ghatannaya. So when someone talks about ghata, bring ghata, take the ghata, you hear these words and then you hear the anuvritti of ghata over and over. There is ghata word being used. Even if you just watch over, you'll learn by repetition that whenever the ghata word has been used and ghata appears in front of you or is taken away, so something that is there in front of you, is used in vyavahara, has been transacted with you with the use of the word ghata. Then you start making associations as a child itself. Look at the creation is such, you know, the nature is such that we observe and learn, we hear and learn. And when we hear something and observe something multiple times, then we associate that heard word with the padartha. So pada and padartha sambandha, which is nitya really. Otherwise, as per the Purvamimamsaka, it conveys some meaning to me. I start making associations, and then that word carries that meaning, it reveals that meaning, it has that shakti to reveal that meaning. So, ghata iti akshara samudaya nama prithu buddha vartulatvadikam rupam. Ghato vartate iti asti, that the ghata exists. Satta is revealed by this. Ghataha vartate, ghataha bhavati, ghata asti. So that astitvam, whether you say ghata vartate or you say pato vartate, you say matha vartate, anything that you say that vartate, bhavati, asti, these words convey what? They convey the astitvam associated in this ghata. Beneath this ghata there is astitvam. In pata also it is there. In matha also it is there. In each and every padartha there is astitvam also. That astitvam is conveyed by the word asti. So, nama, rupa and asti are there in each and every padartha. Ghataha pratiyate iti bhati. Ghata is there, but it appears in front of me. The ghata appears. Ghata appears to be the shabda also. Shabda api pratiyate. The sound is heard. So, easiness is there. Astitvam is there even the sound. And there is also pratiti of the shabda. The hearing is the pratiti. Cognition. The cognition of the ghata is bhana, which is called as bhati here. Appearance of ghata, whether it is in the shabda rupa or in rupa, shabda sparsha rupa rasa gandha, any of the forms it has rupa any which way, and it also has astitvam, it has nama, it has bhana also. It is cognized in some way, so that chetanatvam is revealed in each and every padartha by the mere presence of the chetana vastu associated there as its karana really. As its adhishthana, there is chetanatvam, brahma, vyapaka brahma. So that is associated with the padartha. Each and every padartha will have this bhana also. In an insentient thing, the chetanatvam appears as a revelation of the padartha itself, not as sentience. For sentience, you need antakkarana. Without the antakkarana, the insentient vastu also has chit. How? Otherwise, without that, astitvam will be there. It will be there. But you cannot make a statement that there is. That easiness that you associated with the ghata, ghata asti, astitvam being there does not mean that I can say that it is there. Only when it is revealed to me. For example, in a dark room, there may be a ghata. There is completely pitch dark. Ghata is there. Can you make the statement ghata asti? You cannot make the statement ghata asti. How do you know? Someone says there is no pot within. You look at it, you say there is no pot. But ghata is there. It won't be satya, it won't be. Even if it is satya according to you, it won't be ruta. It will not be a fact. Because ghata is there. So ghata asti is different from ghata bhati. That bhana is due to the chitta underlying, which is there in the padartha, but it is not manifesting. For it to manifest, there has to be particular circumstance that is there. But for you to make a statement that ghataha bhati, some circumstances have to be there. So the padartha has bhana. Let's say there is an owl which sees in the dark. They say the owl sees in the dark. In the same room, there is an owl also. And that owl can see, owl or bat, whatever, you know, those assume that there is some who can see in the dark. That ghata has bhana even if you can't see it. The circumstance is appropriate for the chakshurindriya of anya prani, which can see that bhana. We see that ghata because the circumstances are appropriate for it to see, that bhati which is there in the ghata padartha reveals itself, makes this revelation possible to the anya prani. As soon as the light is there, then it is visible to you also. The bhana is not utpanna, bhana was there, so bhati was already there and now it is visible to you and you say ghata pratiyate iti bhati. Finally, that ananda which is called as priya, ghata priya, the ghata is dear to me or it takes away my priti, is a manifestation of priti itself. It is blocked. So manifestation is blocked by the ghata or is manifest by the prop. So it is either taking you away from the underlying priya tattva or it is taking you close to the underlying priya tattva, but priya tattva is there. Therefore, ghata priya iti priyam. In this way, nama rupa astibhati priyam. So astibhati priyam, nama rupa iti panchakam, adhyatrayam satyam. In this list, not adhyatrayam. In this list, the antyatrayam satyam. Panchadashikara talks about astibhati priya and then nama rupa. There he says adhyatrayam satyam and then the other two are mithya. Here the first two are mithya. Sarpadikam api sarpinyadikasya priyam bhavati. We have seen this yesterday. For a snake, the opposite gender snake is priya. Ittham sarva padartheshu api panchaushaha santi. So you cannot say there is no ananda in sarpa. It may not be there for you. But there are so many snake lovers for them. Snake is real. इत्थं सर्वपदार्थेषु पञ्चांशाः सन्ति तत्र अस्तिभाति प्रियात्मकं अंशत्रयं सर्वपदार्थेषु व्यापकं बट दिस अस्तिभाति प्रियतत्व इज नॉट चेंजिंग अक्रॉस पदार्थास इट इज व्यापक इट इज देयर इन ऑल पदार्थास बट नाम रूप इज आल्सो इन ऑल पदार्थास बट देयर इज नो व्यभिचार बिटवीन अस्तिभाति प्रिय इन वन पदार्थ एंड अनदर पदार्थ ऑफ द सेम स्पीशीज ऑफ अन्य जाति or within the particular ghata ityadi padartha also. So swagata bhede or in other two types of bhedas also, across the padarthas of the same species, across the padarthas of the different species and within the same padartha vyakti, in its parts, aunshas also, these three do not vary. Astibhati priya continue to be vyapaka, whereas namarupam iti aunshadvayam vyabicharati. Namarupa varies across the board, whether it is in the same jati, across the jati, or in the swagata bheda, in the swagata aunshas. One ausha will be different from the other by nama and rupa. Across the jatis or within the jatis also, the vyaktis will differ by nama and rupa. Even in twins, the nama will vary. The rupa may be same. In fact, rupa also differs. Parents are able to make out the difference between even the same as twins. So rupa may be same, appears to be same, but still difference is there. If it is there, obviously the parents won't name the twins as same. Not Ram and Ram, Ram and Shyam. There is some difference because you have to have vyavahara, not possible with the same name in the same rupa. So nama and rupa differ. Yadvastu kvachid vidyate kvachichana vidyate tad vyabhichari iti uchyate. What is vyabhichara, vyabhichari? When you do this anvaya vyatirika, if we don't know, then he is explaining that also. Yadvastu kvachid vidyate, some vastu which is there at some place, kvachichana vidyate, and not there elsewhere, tad vyabhichari ityuchyate. Ghata iti nama prithu buddha vartulatvadi rupancha patena vidyate. In the cloth you do not have the name pot and you don't have the form of the pot. There is no wide neck etc. Narrow neck and the wide mouth and belly isn't there in the cloth. Pata iti nama आतान वितान आत्मत्वादि रूपंच घटेन विद्यते. And whatever is the you know woven form of the cloth, that is not there in the ghata. इत्थं सर्वपदार्थेषु अपि नाम रूपांशौ व्यभिचारिणौ अस्थिभाति प्रियम इति अंशत्रयम् सर्वत्र अनुगतम् अस्ति यथा सर्प दण्डादिषु अनुगते अनुगत इदम् अंशः सत्यः अधिष्ठानं च भवति तथा सर्व पदार्थेषु अनुगताः अस्थिभाति प्रियांशः सत्याः अधिष्ठान रूपाश्च भवन्ति. नाउ ब्रिंगिंग दिस एक्सप्लेनेशन बैक टू द रज्जु सर्पस्थल वेर यू हैव सर्प दंड ऑल दीज आर हैविंग इदम् अंश विच इज सत्य that idamamsha which is satya which is adhisthana which belongs to the rajju it is the rajju swarupa itself tatha sarva padartheshu anugataha asti bhati priyamsha satyah similarly like the idamamsha in rajju which has no vyabhichara the asti bhati priyamsha are satya because they do not have any vyabhichara and they are adhisthana rupascha bhavanti they are the adhisthana rupa रज्जु रूपाय अस्ति भाति प्रिय सर्पदंडादिवत व्यभिचारी नाम सॉरी सर्पदंडादिवत व्यभिचारी नाम रूपांशौ कल्पितौ दि सर्प दंड भूचिद्र दीज आर ऑल नाम रूपास दे आर कल्पित दे डोंट हैव दे आर नॉट रियल पदार्थास एल्सवेयर दे आर रियल पदार्थास बट इन दि रज्जु सर्पस्थल रज्जु दंड दे आर नॉट रियल रज्जु इज रियल सर्पदंडादिवत व्यभिचारी नाम रूपांशौ कल्पितौ द राम रूपास आर कल्पिता लाइक दिस सर्प दंड इत्यादि आर कल्पिता अस्ति भाति प्रियांशः सच्चिदानंद रूपा भवन्ति तस्माद् आत्मस्वरूपा भवन्ति अस्ति भाति एंड प्रिया आर अदर वर्ड्स फॉर सच्चित एंड आनंद दे आर आत्मस्वरूपास they are not different from each other itham sachidananda rupe atmani sampurnah nama rupa prapancha kalpita kalpita padartha kopi atmano janma hetur na bhavati you cannot have any kalpita vastu as janma karana for atma so atma is what janma rahita tasmad atma janma rahita everything other than the atma is kalpita in atma kalpita cannot be a karana janma hetu for atma for anything here the atma happens to be sat Even if you say kalpita vastu is a karana for kalpita vastu, it is not possible. You have to search for a sat karana, which cannot be anything else but atma. Atma itself cannot be the karana of atma. So the janma karana cannot be kalpita. It cannot be atma itself. There is a kartru karma virodha. Therefore, atma is janma rahita. Yasya vastuna janma bhavati tasyeva satta vriddhi parinama ityadi. षड्विकारा वी लुक एट दी टिप्पणा फर्स्ट घटो जायते इति व्यवहार हेतु जन्म नाउ दी षड्विकारा व्हिच आई डिस्कस हियर सत्ता सो सत्ता इज मेंशनड हियर सो सत्ता वृद्धि परिणामः देन यू विल हैव अपक्षय विनाश इति इतरे पंचविकारा भवन्ति दी फाइव विकारास व्हिच फॉलो टू मेक दी सिक्स विकारास दे फॉलो जन्म सो फर्स्ट विकारा इज जन्म सो यस्य वस्तुनः जन्म भवति तस्यैव सत्ता वृद्धि परिणाम इत्यादि दि अदर फाइव विकारास आर पॉसिबल एंड व्हाट इज द सत्ता घटो जायते इति व्यवहार हेतुर जन्म विदाउट द जन्म यू कैन नॉट हैव व्यवहार सो दैट व्यवहार हेतु इज जन्म एज व्हाट घटो जायते इति व्यवहार व्यवहार इज घटा इज क्रिएटेड इज प्रोड्यूस्ड When you say there is the pot is made, that vyavahara is possible and is made possible by the production of ghata. That is the hetu for the conversation also being possible as ghata is made. Otherwise, you cannot make that statement also. Even to say that ghata is made, the ghata has to be made. Something has to be there. Even if you lie about it, that the ghata is not made and the potter says that the ghata is made, it is not made, it is being made. Something has to be there which has been produced for vyavahara of ghata jayate. Ghata jataha, ghata is made. Iti vyavahara hetu astita rupa vikara. So here ghata jayate, you have to take as the ghata is being made. Or either way you say ghata is born. Actually ghata in the case, in the case of ghata, it is not easier to see in comparison to others where you have, you know, something where you can say is born. So there ghato jayate ghatah jata, in English you cannot differentiate is born and is born. So here the is born is or was born. Here you have to say it is in the past tense. So that is the difference. Otherwise ghato jata can be ghata is born also, was born also. When you say is born, the birth has already taken place. So it is in the sense of past tense. So samipya lat lakara is used in the near future and near past also. Similarly in English also you can say someone is born, so that birth has already taken place. So easiness is in the past, really very close. So based on the context, ghato jata iti vyavahara hetu astita rupo vikara. So that asti and janma is differentiated as janma vikara is hetu for ghato jayate iti vyavahara, and ghato jata iti vyavahara hetu is the asti rupa vikara. अयमेव विकार प्रकटता प्रकटते इति सत्ता इति च उच्यते. सो इट इज कॉल्ड इन डिफरेंट वेज आल्सो दिस अस्तिता विकार. एवमेव जातस्य लब्धसत्ताकस्य शिशोः बाल्य यौवनादि प्राप्ति रूपा वृद्धि विकार इज व्हाट वर्धते. सो वर्धते विकार वृद्धि विकार इज व्हेन दिस शिशु जात शिशु. सो नाउ फ्रॉम घटा ही हैज गॉन टू शिशु बिकॉज इट इज ईजियर टू एक्सप्लेन देयर. घटा विल नॉट हैव वृद्धि. वृद्धि इज वॉट एवर यू नो इफ इट इज पेंटेड देन दैट इज द वृद्धि फॉर द घटा. बट हियर द शिशु विच इज बॉर्न वेन द चाइल्ड ग्रोज अप इन टू फ्रॉम द इन्फेंट इट ग्रोज टू अ चाइल्ड टू अ यंग एटसेट्रा. ऑल दिस इज द ग्रोइंग अप इज वृद्धि. ततः वार्धक्य प्राप्ति रूप परिणाम. देन there are some changes in the stagnant stage where there is no growth further, but there is some change which is taking place. All that is parinama. Tatah rogadina karsha rupah apakshaya. Then the disease and old age will shrink the body further. That is called as apakshaya. Tatah marana rupah nashascha iti shadbhav vikara jneya. Then मरण रूप इज नाश विकार. आत्मनो जन्माभावात् तदुत्तर भाविनः पंच विकारा न भवन्ति. द फाइव विकारास हैव टू फॉलो जन्म. विदाउट जन्म यू कैन नॉट हैव व्यवहार. ऑल्दो इन द षड विकारास अस्ति जायते इट इज सेड हाउएवर यू सेड यू नो दीज वर्धते परिणमते अपक्षीयते विनश्यते. देर इनिशियली जायते अस्ति अस्ति जायते कैन बी सेड और जायते अस्ति. इन सम टेक्स्ट यू विल फाइंड दैट अस्ति एंड देन जायते, बट दैट अस्तित्वम इज नॉट मैनिफेस्ट देर. दैट अस्ति विकार इज ओनली पॉसिबल, द डिस्कशन ऑफ अस्तित्वम इज पॉसिबल ओनली व्हेन जन्म इज देर. So that janma is not of the shishu janma there. When you talk about janma as the second vikara in that listing, then that janma vikara is not the shishu janma. There the janma vikara, you talk about janma vikara as a shishu janma, but the janma has already taken place in conception. So in the gestation period, in the womb, when you say the shishu asti, that vyavahara is possible only when it is confirmed that the mother is carrying the child. So for that to be considered and talked about asti, that asti vikara, when you talk about that also there has to be janma of some padartha. So when you're talking about janma of the shishu, that is a second janma. The janma that is the second vikara. But even to talk about that astitvam in the womb, the janma of that has to be there. Something has to be there, that child in the womb, which who cannot be unborn child in the womb, the unborn child in the womb, that unborn that you say is not born out of the womb yet, but he is born in the womb. So therefore, janma precedes astitvam there, or you have to take that astitvam as not as, because asti cannot be a vikara otherwise. The asti in this pancha, panchaamshas, this astitvam which was talked about, the panchaamsha asti, that is not the asti vikara. Asti is a vikara. That vikara is possible, vikara is possible to be described as a vikara only when there is janma. So janma, although listed second in many a text, it is the first vikara. So ajab brahma cannot have other vikaras. That is mentioned here as atmano janma bhavat. Since atma does not have janma, therefore tad uttara bhavinah pancha vikaraha na bhavanti. There is no possibility of five vikaras. Ittham atma janmadi shadbhava vikara rahita iti siddham. So atma is bereft of shadvikara. Atmana asangatva varnanam. We'll look at the asangatva varnana of atma in the next part. Sukam nityam swaprakasham vyapakam namarupa adhishthanam buddhibodhyam buddher drukyattu nirmala param sarva vedanta vedyam pratyak param maha tadeva annamatto nyaditi menishitamatihi. Any questions? नमस्ते.